Gurr not winning any of these traits here and not being able to punish these projectiles from that range. If Cassie were shooting from a little bit closer, Gurr could have the reversal punish. He's trying to find it right now, but he's not going to get at that range. Sonic Fox seems to know the range better.
He's also trying to force it there by flawless blocking, thus recovering a little bit faster here, but it's not enough. And Sonic Fox all over it.
He's got to be much closer, but the closer he gets, the harder it is to flawless block, and so he gets hit as he tries to advance.
Can we talk about how many of those flawless blocks he did connect there?
Yeah.
Looking for the fatal blow so desperately as Sonic Fox just walks out of that range.
Yeah, just barely walks back and shoots another one. Sonic Fox with the perfect spacing. That's full screen footsies right there. I like to say that zoning is just an extension of footsies applied to projectiles. And Sonic Fox, I think, is proving it. Barely backing away enough to whiff punish the fatal blow projectile with his own projectile. Good check from Sonic Fox. Knowing to not shoot the amplify shot, knowing that Gurr had breakaway and used it. Sonic Fox's resource awareness is incredible. He's looking at the screen with such discipline. He'll only spend the amplify when the opponent doesn't have breakaway, just like there. And so he amplifies the gun strike, gets the combo, misses it, but still worth getting a little bit more damage. Gurr gets the hit confirm though, plenty of damage on the table for him. And so we see the breakaway.
Second bracket against Splash, and Gurr looking like he's the one that wants to take that honor and take it home for Brooklyn.
Wow, but he's not going to be able to do it. If he uses Gyarus' standard best string, which Cassie has the option to low profile with Nut Kick, Sonic Fox shutting that down hurts so bad for Gyarus. He now has to get way more creative in how he presses in neutral. 4-2-1-2 is Gyarus' best string, best tool, and so it's negated by that Nut Kick. Sonic Fox has the tech, and he has it at the ready, and he now took Gurr's breakaway as well because Sonic Fox is not amplifying those gunshots if Gurr has breakaway. He's getting resources stolen from his opponent just for free by looking at the screen and making decisions based on what he sees by these meters. Sonic Fox dominant now in Losers Finals. Sonic Fox, the mallet overhead is just nailing people today.
Yes, it's so unexpected, and you think the string is over, you think it's your turn to swing, but Gurr utilizing those interactables as he is kinged himself, the master of interactables.
I love how cartoony that interactable is as well, because it won't get us banned from YouTube in the same way that the Gyarus Crushing Blow will.
Or the Q-tip.
Also, yes, too violent. Gurr now in a great position to take this round. Trying to pressure Sonic Fox. About 18% life. One more whiff punish will certainly do it. One more throw. Even chips can be coming effect. Wow. I cannot believe that Gurr just went with the unsafe special there. On a string where there's no mix-up, he was trying to catch Sonic Fox counter poking, but it didn't work, and so Sonic Fox is getting a lot of free damage now.
It hurts.
Oh my god, could this be the end? Could it be this mistake he'll regret for the rest of his life? He goes for wake up too, and that is the final mistake in this set. Sonic Fox takes it cleanly with a disciplined comeback, one tool at a time and one mistake at a time from Gurr, exposed by Sonic Fox, taking it 3-0, even with a clutch comeback, punishing that wake up too.
Here's Cusco running away with this in the first round, and this is where it's gonna hurt. Sonya in the corner does so much damage. Yep. What's gonna be the 50-50? The low, gonna cancel, gonna do more damage.
Twice in a row, he's gotten the back one for the max optimal damage in the corner. That's the first time we've seen a Sonya player do that, and then the second time, shortly after, Cusco showing he's the optimal Sonya right now.
Can he make this comeback? Deadly Rebel on the verge, on the brink of elimination here in the lower bracket. Escape failed. He gets the back throw. The crushing blow for 31%.
And he has fatal blow, which will kill.
There it is.
Yep. Right on cue. Right on cue.
He called it out perfectly. And what a whiff punish here. Yep. Sonic Fox overextending here and looking at elimination right in the eye. Never mind.
Not spending crushing blow yet is Ludi. Pretty confident in this first round. Gets the entire stand one. And safely runs away from the Numa Dash. It's actually very dangerous for Cabal to do combos against Breakaway, just because there is so much potential for his Numa Dash to get punished. Thankfully, he made it over. Dominating Sonic Fox right now. Sonic Fox had no defense bar left. Scott was either going to get hit by that air buzzsaw or get chipped out soon.
As he does have full meter, but instead just gets aggressive.
Advancing forward one from Pella. Oh, and Sonic Fox walks to the other side, gets the whiff punish, trip guard. Sonic Fox takes it clean in the reset. 3-0, one of the fastest 3-0s I've ever seen.
Ready to swing, pushing him closer to the corner where it is a viable, especially when you're considering the Oki, a big jump in as Sonic Fox is trying to challenge here. Splash converting into all this damage, 40% clean, no problem.
Okay, now this is the Splash we know, the Splash that is not afraid to jump. He is a Kun Lao player and he knows he has dive kick and jump kick options, and in the corner he knows the jump kick leads to amazing damage. We haven't even seen that much in the way of anti-airs from Sonic Fox. Great duck under the string. Splash misses the down two. He wanted to keep it simple and go through breakaway. Sonic Fox didn't spend the breakaway, and so the combo misses. He's on the verge of making his comeback. Splash about to be very haunted by this round if this goes the wrong way. Looking for Chip, gets the air-to-air. Splash saves himself.
He believed. Get jumping out and Splash, you're right. This is the Splash we want to see.
There he is again. Oh, but this time Splash gets ducked under. He did his jump kick real high to try and mess with Cassie trying to anti-air with a stand one. Sonic Fox ducks, and wow. Didn't learn anything from Chris G getting hit by that jailing string earlier. Splash really in trouble here. Running out of life, certainly out of defense bar. Fatal Blow is his only positive resource right now, and so he loses that too, and he loses the game. Probably feeling good about that one, but not feeling good getting hit in the nuts and being put back in the court and getting his wake up baited and punished. Meterless launch for Cassie in the corner. You have to be very afraid of waking up against her in the corner, knowing that her whip punishes are so potent and the damage she gets in the corner is so high.
Oh, and again, Sonic Fox making that jump in whip.
Wow. Yeah.
I mean, I think Splash is going to have to commit to some kind of dive kick, and I know that's very unsafe.
Rolls through, whip punish. Splash has to not drop this. Fatal blow on the table for both players. Splash spends it. It's going to do a lot of damage.
It does a lot of damage, but it's going to be scaled heavily here as you see it just ticking down. Sonic Fox, less than 10%.
We haven't seen
less
the teleport yet. Is it time?
No.
Is it time to teleport? Is it time? Throw tech. Splash commits the dive kick and loses the tournament. It is Sonic Fox. Winning so clean in this reset.
Oh,
exciting,
man.
That Splash did commit to the dive kick that we foreshadowed, because Son of Fuck was ducking jump-ins and anti-airing them, but mostly ducking them, and that's what really messed with Splash's head. But even Son of Fox was prepared for that single adjustment. The adaptations were being made in advance,
and so it's
Son of Fox proving once again one of the greats.
Oh, hey, good job out there, by the way. That was cool.